Hello everyone, welcome to Mechanical Sati. So today in this video we are going to discuss a question from your isometric view. Okay, so if in a question it will be given that orthographic view will be given and it will be asking to find out it will be asking to draw the isometric view, then how can we draw that? Okay, so this will be the simple case and we'll be trying to get the isometric view from the given figure. Okay, so if you will you have not subscribed our channel, do subscribe it and press on the bell icon so that you will never miss any updates from our channel. Okay, so without wasting time, let us move forward and try to solve the given question here. Okay, so question is given, that is draw the isometric view from the given orthographic view. Orthographic view is given here, and if we can see, then if we'll see properly here, say then we can find out this will be the front view over here, and this will I can say that is left hand side view, and this will be your top view. So if I can mark like this, then I can say that this is drawn in first angle projection. So first thing we need to see, in which angle of projection it is drawn. Okay, so from here we can get that this is drawn in first angle projection. So next we need to get idea about the parent feature. Okay, so first where we need to start the drawing, that we need to find out over here. Okay, so if we'll see here, so total length of this block or that product or drawing, we can say, so this is the length we can say, and this is the width. Okay, so in the top view we can see, we can get two dimensions. Okay, so this is one and this is another one. So length of the drawing will be 70 plus 70, that will be 140, and width we can say that is 30 plus 30 plus 30, that will be 90. Okay, so first thing what we need to do, we need to draw a rectangular block. Okay, or rectangle you can say first. So rectangle, which will be dimension, length will be 70 and your width will be 90. Okay, so next, okay, let us draw that first. So if we'll draw that, for starting the drawing, what we need to do, we need to draw a horizontal line over here, then we need to draw two lines which will be 30 degree to the horizontal line. So we can say this angle will be 30 degree and this angle will be 30 degree. Okay, so with this only we need to start the drawing. Then what we need to do, we need to draw that rectangle. So in in this letter, this is 140 we take, and this is 90 we take. So with this we need to draw a rectangle over here. Okay, so we can draw a rectangle over here, so we can get a rectangle somewhat like this. So after getting this, if we'll see, then height of the block we can get from these two diagrams. Okay, so that is front view and left hand side view. So if we'll see, then total height of the block we can say that is 30 plus 30 plus 30, so that is 30 plus 40 plus 30. Okay, total will be your 100 we can say. So out of 100, here 30 or here 30 we can say. So we have to make a rectangular block with height 30. Okay, already we have made that rectangle, and we have to make that rectangular block. So height will be 30 over here. So with height 30 we need to draw a rectangular block. So the block will be somewhat like this, where your height will be 30. So if we'll be dimensioning here, so then this height will be 30, and this length will be 140. Okay, and this width will be 90. Okay, so all the dimensions we can dimension here. Okay, according to this three dimension you can draw a rectangular block over here. So if we'll draw that rectangular block, then I will be get a figure like this. Okay, so after getting this rectangular block, what we need to do, we need to erase these lines which will be not visible in isometric view. So what we need to do, we need to erase these lines. Okay, so after erasing we'll be getting a figure like this. So this will be the figure after erasing those lines. Okay, so next thing what we need to do, so if we'll be seeing in the top view, okay, let me use the pointer. So If we'll see in the top view, in this region actually there will be no material, but in our rectangular block we have given some material over here. So what we need to do, we need to remove material from over here. So accordingly given dimension, we need to remove that material. Okay, so what dimension is given here? So this thickness that is given 30, and if we'll get this dimension, okay, so that is not given over here, so we can assume this will be 30. Okay, so by leaving 30 over here, and we can draw three lines over here. So let us draw that. Okay, so if we'll draw that over here, then what I can do, so while leaving 30 mm over here, I can draw a line. Okay, so again we'll see here also, this is 30, okay, and this is 30. So by leaving 30 mm from here, okay, so we need to draw a straight line, and again from like by leaving 30 mm from here, we need to draw a straight line. Okay, so let us draw those three two lines also. So we'll be getting a line like this, and another line like this. Okay, so we got a rectangle over here. Okay, so now what we need to do, we need to extend these lines to end. Okay, so if we'll draw this line, okay, these lines, then we'll be getting a figure like this. So let us watch that figure. So this figure will be somewhat like this. Okay, next thing what we need to do, we need to draw a line over here and a line over here, and we have to join this. Okay, so we'll, after drawing this, we can get a figure like this. Okay, so next one, what we need to do, as given in the figure, there will be no material in this region. So what we need to do, we need to erase these lines which will be not visible. Okay, so if we'll erase those lines, then we can okay, so which line should be erased, that if we'll see, then this line will be erased. So let me use the pointer again. So this line will be erased, and this line, that is this line will be erased, and this line will be erased, and this line will be erased, and this line will be up to this much only, and this lower portion of the line will be erased. Okay, so after erasing all these lines, then we can get a figure like this. Okay, so let us next see what is given else. Okay, so again, if we'll see here, so this feature is given, everything is drawn, only this feature and this feature we need to draw. Okay, so already we have drawn all these things. Okay, next we have to consider about this feature. Okay, so if we'll see in the front view, it is somewhat here, and if we'll be seeing in the side view, it is somewhat here. So from side view, we can say that it is on the left region. Okay, so we can see at here only your this feature is available. So let us draw that. So how can we draw that? So we can see this feature is available in this region, then how can we draw? So let us draw that. Then what we need to go 70 mm, because in dimension it is given, it is 40 and it is 30, so we need to go above 70, and here also we need to go 70, because here it is given 70. Again we need to go down, that is 30. Okay, and again here it is, we can say 40, and this is 30. Okay, so we need to draw this feature over that. Okay, so this will be 70, then here again 70, then 30, then 40, then your 40. Okay, so after getting this feature, what we need to do, we need to extend this up to 30 mm, so we can get another figure like this. Okay, with this we can say our drawing is completed. Okay, so how will be visible? So our figure will be looking like this somewhat. Okay, so now what we need to do, we need to erase all those lines which will be not visible. So let us see which lines will be not visible. Okay, so this line will be not visible, and this line will also not visible, this line, okay, and this line, and this line also. So all these lines should be erased. Okay, so after erasing all these lines, so we can get a figure like this. Okay, so this will be our final figure. So to finalize it, we need to darken all those lines which will be visible to us. Another thing, this line also will not be visible. Okay, so after darkening, we'll be get a figure like this. Okay, So this will be our final figure. So to finalize it, again we have to give all the dimensions here. So we can say this is, this was 140 and this total was 90 and this height was 10, and from here to here that was given 70, and here to here it was again given 70, and this was 30, and here to here that was 40. So you can give all the dimensions here. So I have given some of those dimensions over here, so I was getting a figure like this. So with this we have completed that figure. Okay, we have got the isometric view of that orthographic projection. Okay, so I think we can say we have reached at the end of lecture for today. Okay, for this video. So if you like this video, press on the like button. Okay, and share with your friends. Okay, and do subscribe our channel and press on the bell icon so that you will never miss any updates from our channel. So thank you for watching.